Are you tired of hunting through long menus to make an aircraft change? What about the weather? Going through several screens simply to make an overcast layer? Well, no longer will you have to suffer through that. Now, with our new application, Sim Control, you will be able to change airports, change aircraft, change weather variables, invoke many failures. And here are some Sim Control screenshots. This is an example of the weather page. This is an example of the failure page. Here is a screen selector for selecting aircraft. Here's a list of airports for relocating the aircraft, as well as positioning it on the runway. The Sim Control app features an IFR chart for the US database. The aircraft will fly over the IFR chart while connected with Sim Controls. We have a few buttons to center on aircraft, clear the flight path, or show a compass right over the map. When selecting an airport, you have three choices: ICAO, airport name, or city name. Simply press the field, type in the desired airport identifier. Once selected, press done, swipe your finger to select the runway, and then push 10, 15, 5, or on the runway to reposition your aircraft right over the runway. The runway reposition should be instant. Then when selecting aircraft, simply select the aircraft in the list and confirm the variation on the top right of the screen. You also have choices: filling the fuel tanks, recharging the batteries, or even a quick engine start. Now onto the weather screen. You have an upper layer and a lower layer, as well as time selection for changing your simulator time. In the upper and lower layer, you have several visibility options, as well as speed options and wind direction. Turbulence, icing are all fixed, or you can simply set to download weather from the internet. In other words, live METAR. When using the failure page, you have various instrumentations, radios, simple systems, or even engines that can be toggled for failure. These also can be triggered in a random failure mode. In other words, pick a time and the amount of systems that you want failed. Select enabled, and then the iPad will pick a random number of failures to be triggered. In the last page, we have quick links for support if you need any help with the application, or if you want to send us a suggestion for future releases of the app, We're always looking for good, productive feedback. Thanks for watching.